So the first personality theory that we're going to discuss is psychoanalytic theory, which was created by Sigmund Freud. And Freud made at least four major assumptions in explaining personality. The first assumption he made was about the power of the unconscious. And that is, the unconscious mind is much more important in shaping our personality than the conscious mind. And in fact, the metaphor that he used is of the iceberg. And the tip of the iceberg is consciousness. It's just a small little part of who we are. What's really important is below the surface, and that's the unconscious mind. So the second major assumption that Sigmund Freud made was that the human mind has three provinces. So the first province of mind is what Sigmund Freud called the id, and that's the seat of our impulses, our desires, pleasure-oriented. It's all about want. The second province of mind was what he called the ego. And the ego is our sense of self. And it's realistic. And finally, we have the superego. And that is the sense of control of our impulses, conscience, knowing right from wrong. So what makes these three provinces so interesting is that there's a conflict, inherent conflict between the id on the one hand and the superego on the other, between impulse, wanting something, and controlling that impulse. In fact, we often can depict this as a fight that we have ourselves between our angel side and our devil side. The devil tells us to do it, we want it, and the angel says no. So the third assumption that Sigmund Freud made is that personality is shaped by early childhood experiences. Now this may not seem so radical to us, but understand that in the day, people did not make that assumption. They assumed childhood experiences really didn't matter much. Freud argued otherwise. So the last major assumption that Freud made, and one of his big contributions, was the idea of defense mechanisms. And defense mechanisms are like our immune system, but for our mind. They keep threatening ideas and thoughts and motives out of consciousness. So two of the better known defense mechanisms that Freud talked about were repression and reaction formation. And in repression, we're keeping these threatening ideas and thoughts and feelings out of consciousness. And the main thoughts and feelings and impulses that we repress are sexual and aggressive impulses. So with reaction formation, we turn a threatening impulse into its exact opposite. So for instance, a parent who might harbor unconscious feelings of hostility towards a child, but those feelings are too threatening, so they turn it into its opposite and become smothering with affection. Likewise, another example might be homophobia, when someone is threatened by their own latent homosexual impulses and turns that impulse into hostility towards those who express homosexual behavior.